Welcome back, Maniacs. Today we're going to be taking a look at the Hammer of God version 3. What we're going to be doing is we're going to do similar to like what I did with the Big Pig. This is going to be like a first impressions, just kind of touring the device. And then about a month later from now, I'll go ahead and, you know, come back and tell you how I was getting along with it, if there's anything that bothers me or I find super exceptional or anything of that nature. Let me adjust a little bit of light here. Okay. So, like I said, this is the Hammer of God V3. I got this yesterday and I'm just very excited about it. So let's go ahead and start at the beginning. And the first thing we'll do is we'll take a look at the packaging. Comes in your standard Vapor's Cloud box. Kind of plain but very classy looking. You get your authenticity card, which actually means something with this one. And then you get this piece of paper here, which is going to white out something fierce. Hold on, let me kill some of this damn light. Maybe we can, there we go. So you get this little piece of paper right here. And I wanted to kind of draw your attention to, let's see here, do I got a pointer? I don't have much in the way of a pointer, but right there. Do not use this product in any sexual nature. I got to be honest with you here, Vapor's Cloud. Y'all some bad son bitches if y'all can figure out a way to use this in a sexual nature. That's pretty awesome. That's really all this piece of paper is warnings of do's and don'ts and stuff like that. There is, as far as I can tell, no actual user manual for this. I've looked online, just can't seem to find anything. So, whoop, let me put something in the damn picture. There we go. All right, so that's our box. And then a little card. And then, of course, said device, the Hammer of God. Now, you'll notice right away it looks a little bit different. Get it from a top view. It's kind of got these rounded corners, which are super duper comfortable. Okay, so we have the logo on this side, very well engraved. I'm going to see if I can't get a better close-up of that here in a minute. Nothing on that side. There's our fire switch and the serial number, number 124. And then nothing on that side. Logo again. We have our bottom and our top. So let's kind of go through this thing and kind of show you some of the things. Now I've got my version 2 out and we're going to do a little size comparison and stuff, but the major changes from the version 2 to the version 3, I'm going to get a little bit more light on here. Hopefully it's not going to wash out too terrible hard. Okay, so first off, let's try to look at this engraving. I mean, this engraving is exceptional by any measure. It is nice, it is deep, it is clean. This is what we've come to expect from Vapor's Cloud, just a high quality look to it. I mean, these things just look amazing. We've got, sorry, that's, I don't know what the hell that was on there. I'll just, fuzzies, I guess. Yeah. We've got, this is painted straight up black. Wow, this thing is collecting dust like nobody's business. Of course, I've been using it. So let me amp this light back down just a shade. All right, so the numbering or the serial number is just engraved just as deeply as the front. See if I can get that to come in. There we go. Very nice indeed. So let's talk about some of the differences here. Obviously, the rounded edges, and then the switch is not protruding. It's just like a VCP, smooth, flush with the body. Okay. And then, of course, you load your batteries in the bottom instead of in the side. So this is our bottom door. I sure would just be tickled shitless if it fucking focus. All right, come on, baby. Focus in. All right, well, apparently that's as good as my shitty little camera is going to get. So we've got a little quick release latch right here. And we have venting right there that goes all the way through. We have a little tab right here to lock it into place on the other side. Well, same thing. Lock it into place on the other side. Okay. Right there. And then here is your bottom contacts. And it looks to be silver plated, whatever. I can't find anything on a website or anything about it as far as what the component is, but it looks like it's silver plated. Okay. So, boy, I tell you what, I got extreme lighting issues here. Let's see here. Turn that. Alright, so is that any better? Can I get any focus here? Apparently not. Alright. So let's just oversaturate this bitch. There we go. So that's what our contacts look like. Okay. Now, I want you to notice on here, go around that side, come around this side here. This side here. This will make sense in a minute, y'all. This side here. Alright. And looking on the silver contacts themselves, there are no markings whatsoever. Okay? That's kind of important. Okay. So there we go. I'll look at it from this side. Alright, so that's our bottom piece. Wow, washed out like a son of a bitch. Jesus. There we go. Alright, so that's our bottom piece. Here we have the inside of it. As you can see, we've got five screws holding that all in. That's looking like that silver plated whatever. If it falls within normal vapors cloud crap, it's silver plated copper. But I don't know for a fact. We have our plus symbol, and then if you can see it, if I can get it just right, well, see, I brought in a prop for this one because I noticed on the camera earlier that I couldn't see the son of a bitch. But we look. There's plus and minus. So there's where your polarity markings are. Alright, so far this is turning out to be one of the crappiest videos I've ever done. Pretty impressive. Let's stop and take a vape, shall we? Alright. So that's what your inside of it looks like. These are just too freaking cool. Just a superb use of space. Just an absolute awesome use of space. If we take a battery, it won't fit in there. You know what I mean? You have to actually slide it down in there and it won't come out. You know what I mean? That is just fantastic. Just beautifully, beautifully done. So then we'll pop up here to the top. We have a adjustable 510 with screw, just like most other Vapors Clouds products. I don't know if you can catch that there or not, but that is a screw. It looks to be the same silver plated kind of stuff. Well, that's just grr, most annoying. Let's see if we can't shred just a little bit of light on that. Nope, it's going to wash out. Anything? Nope. All right. Well, there's a screw there, I promise. I'm not going to fib to you. There's an actual screw there. All right, there we go. We can kind of see it a little bit better if we turn it around. There we go. All right, so, yeah, let me apologize for this here video, because, boy, I'll tell you what, this using this background was probably not the wisest of ideas. It's reflecting light some fierce. So, all right, so to insert your batteries, you just find your positive, and your positives go up. I mean, those batteries aren't moving. I mean, it's kind of cool how they did that. And then your negatives will go on this side. And it's that simple. No tools are required, nothing. This is absolutely brilliant. All right, and then you just take your cap, put it on, and there you go. You have a finished product. It feels very good in the hand as far as weight goes when it's got batteries in it. It's absolutely stunning. All right, just everything about this is absolutely gorgeous. I love this thing to death. We'll take for a minute. This is the version 2. As you can see, there's quite a substantial size difference between the two of these things. And obviously, you know, the big huge differences are the buttons. This is really, you know, one of those protruding things. And they did away with the voltmeter as well. The engraving looks to be pretty much the same. The engraving on this one looks so much cleaner. I don't know what the deal is there. I don't know, maybe they're getting better. I don't know. But it's just, you notice the letters, especially if you look at the word hammer, just the engraving on it. And I mean, in real life, this looks really nice. I mean, this camera is not really doing it much in the way of justice. But the camera's picking this up just beautifully. And I mean, that is just stunning, stunning work, okay? And then obviously with the version 2, you have to screw those damn screws in. But that's what a size comparison looks like between the two of them. If we just match them up, you can kind of see that you've got quite a bit more length. Let's see here. That's a little bit overhang there. It's just rounded off. It's just so much nicer. So this is a fine device. I love this thing. It just doesn't feel comfortable. Whereas this one just, oh, it just fits the hand so well. All right, so today the Addy I'm using is the Buddha version 3. Got my series, oh yeah, and this runs, of course, in Para series, just like the other ones. An interesting side note that I was reading on their website is apparently this is the last Hammer of God in the series. They're not making any more Hammers of God. So, and as you can see, she's firing off just the thing. A little on the dry side. Probably should have juiced that up first. But, alright. So let's go over so far some of the things about this that may be cause for concern, maybe not. It's entirely up to you. I want to preface this by saying that this does not affect any of the things I'm fixing to say. If I'd known about them beforehand, it would not have affected my decision to buy this. These are just little niggles that I wished they'd have done it a little different in some ways. But I still consider this probably one of the best devices in the hand and for power and just all around aesthetics that I own. Okay. Give you a little cloud show. Ooh, so awesome. Look at that, man. So foggy. All right, so the first thing, that button. Now, we'll see if we can get this on camera. And we probably won't be able to because I'm not that awesome. Is the throw on this thing is huge. I mean, this is... it goes down a long freaking way. It doesn't feel as good. I would rather it been just, you know, you give it a nice little press, just a little and it fire off. But instead, I mean, Jesus, do I not have anything here? Well, I tell you what, I came unprepared to this party. But it's just, that is just a huge freaking throw, man. Huge. And it's not as comfortable, you know what I mean? I could see where, had that throw been a millimeter or two shorter, it probably would have been a whole lot more comfortable, okay? Let me get a little bit more right there, okay. Wow, nice washout yet again. There we go, how's that? No, not quite there yet, all right. So that's about as good as that's getting. So that's my first little thing with it. It's not a negative. It's not. It does not detract from it in one bit. It's just as a, for a comfort thing, a little more shallow of a push. I mean, that's freaking hard. That would have been nicer. Okay. As I said earlier, if you remember the version 2, that little card didn't mean shit. There was no corresponding serial number on the version 2. That is a nice touch. Finally. Oh, they match. Yay. Because I have a authenticity card for my version 2. Don't mean shit because there is no corresponding number. All right. Nothing wrong up there. Let's see here. Now, the biggest one. This one took me a while to figure out. What we're going to do is I'm going to prove to you that what I'm saying is not, you're not, I'm not full of shit, okay? Matter of fact, let me, where'd my juice go? Well, shit. Well, I'll put some of this on here. I'll fire it both ways just to show you that apparently it makes no difference, but what I would have really have loved to seen, and I know this is for advanced users, don't crucify me here, I get that, but there are no polarity markings on this, okay? And as you can see, it looks kind of fucking specific, like it's meant to go a particular way, okay? So when I got it home, the first thing I did when I took it off, I didn't pay attention to the way it came off. So when I put it back on, I just put it in what I thought would be a normal configuration, okay, which is the back switch facing the back towards the number. And let's go ahead and throw this on here. It fires, okay, no fuss, no muss. So I was wondering, well, is this thing going to work any other way? So take this back off because it's full of juice. I don't want to turn it upside down. So will it work? Oh, and how this is catching on there, let me chunk these batteries out real quick. I don't know if you can see this, but this is a lip right here at the edge, and that's what these things are catching on to, the little tabs. So where you see the silver is, that's the metal, and then you have the lip right there. Can kind of see it there. right, so that's what it's catching on to. So there's no one specific spot, you know, for the lip itself. That's kind of what I was looking for to begin with. So our configuration, what we already did once, was that way facing the numbers. So let's just turn it to the side. Okay, so now we are perpendicular to the 124. And boy, I was scared to do this the first time because this thing was fucking expensive. It works just fine. So there doesn't seem to be any particular way that you have to put this in. Me personally, I'm just going to put it in with the number just so I do it the same way all the time. But there we go. So unscrew this. But it would have been nice. I mean, I'm an experienced vapor. Okay, you know, I've been doing this for a minute. I've got all manner of series and stacked and all other type of devices, but that kind of threw me for a loop. I just sat there and there was no literature anywhere about, you know, if it had to go a certain direction, which led me to believe that it was made to go any direction. So that's, like I say, it would not have stopped me, but it would have been nice to have some sort of orientation markings on there. But obviously it's not needed, so now we know why they didn't do that. But those are really, so far, the only things that I have found with this thing that, and we'll pull out old version 2 here and side by side while I'm jabbering. That's really the only thing so far that I've come up with as far as, you know, little niggles with it. Nothing major, nothing certainly to detract me from buying the son of a bitch. So there we have it. On Vapor's Cloud website, they are out of stock right now. Today is like the 16th or something. Yeah, today's the 16th of September. As of today, they're out of stock. They go online on their website for $179. Let's go ahead and kill that a little bit more. I bought mine at a brick and mortar, paid $200 for it. It was $200 with four batteries, the four Sony VTC4s. So kudos to that shop. They didn't give me a discount, so I'm not giving them a freaking shout out. that's just the way it is, folks. If you want your name on screen, well, you know, knock $5 off and you get your name on screen. So I think that just about wraps it up. Like I says, I'll come back in a few weeks and we'll talk about how I've been getting along with it. But so far, that's literally all there is to it. It's very simple. And of course, I'm not going to take apart underneath there. I don't need to see what's behind the curtain. But all right, well, thank you for watching this video. Please subscribe or like if you liked what I did here. Could use a subscriber or two. I think I'm up to 12 now, and I'm very thankful that I have that 12. But you know, I could go for a couple more, I guess. Well, that'll be about all for now. Thanks for watching. Stay, you know, this is Maniacal Vapes. Have a great day.